The first Avengers Endgame trailer has a lot more to it than meets the eye. In my last fan theory video, I pointed out how Tony's hands seem very similar in positioning to a movement made by Ultron in the original AOU trailer. This got me thinking even deeper, and I started to wonder, what if the big bad villain that has been hinted at as being a bigger power than Thanos is in fact one that we have already encountered before? Of the 14 million futures that Doctor Strange witnessed, it's safe to assume that the one where the heroes beat Thanos is the one that he forced to play out when he handed over the Time Stone. It was pretty evident that the character needed Stark alive in order to carry this victory out, which is why he sacrificed himself to save Tony. What if the reason that he played out such a move is because he knew Stark would bring Thanos down with one of his creations? The Endgame concept and name itself is something that first appeared in Age of Ultron when Tony was defending his creation. In that film, he stated, "We can bust arms dealers all the livelong day, but that up there, that's the endgame." This of course came to fruition with Thanos destroying half of all life in the universe during the snap. From other fan theories and clips, it seems that the Avengers will most likely use time travel in order to stop Thanos before he can retrieve the stones. However, whilst this is happening, Thanos is still out there, and if he realizes the plan, he will likely be coming to stop it. So, who will defend Earth whilst the Avengers are gone? To me, it makes the most sense to bring an upgraded Ultron back with the mistakes of the past fully rectified. In Vision, Tony and Banner were able to change Ultron's AI and make it have a different perspective on the world. This is even mentioned in Infinity War when discussing the character, and they note that Vision is even made up of parts of Ultron. We know that Endgame is Robert Downey Jr.'s last movie, so to me it makes sense to bring his arc to a close with the redemption of one of his biggest mistakes. There even existed concept art for Avengers Infinity War that saw Stark standing before a lineup of Iron Man suits, and whilst that had no place in the prior movie, perhaps it was used for this one instead. Of course, this is just a theory, but I'd love to see it play out in the film's final cut. If you disagree or agree with me, then let me know below, and if you enjoyed this video, then please like it and check out my breakdown of this week's other big comic book movie, Aquaman, which will be linked at the end. This is a channel for people who are super into superheroes, so if that's the kind of thing you like, hit subscribe. Thanks again for taking the time to watch this. I've been Deffinition, you've been the best, and I'll see you next time. Take care, peace.